Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another episode of Crappy Pastas. Now, initially I thought I was going to get Mudahar from Some Ordinary Gamers in on this, but I'm going to be straight with you. This initially was an episode of Long Pasta Friday, or just Creepy Pasta Friday. Sadly, this turned into Crappy Pastas for some inexplicable reason. Dear God, this is one of the worst, unintentionally awful stories I've ever read. This story needs to be burned. I mean, normally I do 2 to 3, but this story is just so bad that it almost rivals. I mean, like, it's so badly written that it's physically hard to read. I had to ad lib 99% of this story. It is just that bad. This is your host, That Creepy Reading, presenting Max and Ruby 004, the idea that almost was good. Let's begin. It was just this Christmas that went by, and things were getting pretty busy. I had to start buying presents for the family, and, well, I just finished shopping. But the thing that was still on my list, that one little itching, nagging thing on that damn list, was, well, I still need to grab a present for my little cousin. Now, she's not very hard to shop for, since she's like 4. And, you know, she likes things like Peppa Pig and My Little Pony, among other things. She really liked, and I say liked for a reason, Max and Ruby. So when I decided to go looking for a present, I figured something like Max and Ruby DVD box set or something along those lines would have been perfect, since she liked to watch it on a daily basis. However, Christmas meant that most online DVDs were sold out on places like Amazon, and God forbid I go on eBay to find just like a broken or scratch or a disc with a penis drawn on it. Anyway, all that type of thing. So I went on eBay, despite, you know, what I just said, and I couldn't really find a disc that was in a condition that I would have liked it to be in. So I was stuck in a rut for a while. Until a package arrived. I was at home, still scrolling for stupid fucking DVDs, until I heard the sound of something being pushed through my letterbox. I caught a hold of it before my dog did and started looking at the package. It seemed to be wrapped fairly badly with what looked like grease marks and Cheeto stains on it. Naturally, like anyone, I decided to open a package to see what the fuck is going on and what is inside it. What was inside is something that, well, I still can't really explain to this day. For some odd and unexplainable reason, it was a Max and Ruby DVD, but I had not seen anything like it online. It was as if some little kid had drawn on the front cover with a crude Sharpie marker. Here, why don't I show you what it's like on screen? The title just read Max and Ruby with what looked like a poorly drawn illustration of Max and Ruby on the front. There were no names or anything like that, but on the back it had a list of 4 episodes, all with the very blunt titles, which I'll show on screen right now. I gave the DVD a watch over, and to my surprise, and on contrary to most of these lost episodes, they were all in seemingly perfect quality and seemed to have no flaws whatsoever. The only way I could explain it is if it was, well, a real DVD with just a homemade cover. The only thing I thought was really odd was on the episode selection screen. The episode had names, but they were all called Max and Ruby 1, and so on and so on, and the numbers would just simply be changed as it went down on the list. The actual selection screen was just plain white with black text with the episode list and nothing else. Again, I'll show you on screen right here. And, after giving it much thought, I decided that a change in cover might be a little needed. So, I went on Google and tried printing something a little bit nicer out. And I also managed to track down the names of the episodes so that they would be labeled right on the back of the DVD. I left the episode list on the screen alone because, well, I figured it would be pretty self-explanatory. Christmas went by, and all things are fine. I gave my cousin her DVD and she was happy with it all through Christmas. But that was only because she hadn't watched it yet. On Boxing Day, the family had gone out for a meal and left me to babysit my cousin. I was not too bothered about being left home alone, but I figured now would be as good as any to put into the DVD that I just got for her. I put the DVD in the DVD player and let it play, while I was in the kitchen eating my dinner. From what I could hear, she had watched episodes 1, 2, 3 so far, and I had just about finished off my noodles when I heard my cousin screaming from the other room. Dropping everything, I ran into the living room and I saw my cousin curl up on the floor just screaming as loud as she could. I looked up at the TV and I felt my heart in my throat. What I caught a glimpse of was one of the most disturbing images I had ever seen, which I got on the screen for you now. It's what appeared to be a frame of Max and Ruby standing next to each other in complete darkness. But what made it so horrible was their lack of faces. They had lost all their noses, mouths, and their eyes were replaced with two big black hollow holes. Their colors were a disgusting blood red and faint static in the background. And to top it all off, the noise was replaced to with what sounded like the Max and Ruby theme playing in background, with faint sounds of static playing in the mix of it. It, quite frankly, was one of the most disturbing things I had ever seen, and it must have been on the screen for a solid 20 seconds before the screen went to black and the DVD turned itself off, which alone was weird for a DVD, because they usually do not turn themselves off, quite frankly. After a solid 10 seconds, I managed to freaking snap out of it, and I was able to calm my cousin down by telling her it wasn't real, and she just had a nightmare, and she'd fallen asleep in front of the DVD, and, well, it was an odd experience trying to explain to her how she had a nightmare even though she felt completely awake. But I knew in my heart that that was the right thing to do, as if I told her it was a nightmare, she would simply forget about it in time, and it's not something a little child should see at that age, and even though I knew in my mind it was completely real, she did not need to know. So simply, I picked her up, set her off to bed, turned on some cartoons, ones that weren't from an odd DVD this time, and decided to have a smoke to calm my nerves. While I was smoking, my parents had rung me up and, with just my luck, told me that they were going to be out all night. Though I figured this was going to be the best chance and opportunity I was going to have to look at the DVD a little bit more closely. I did not mention it to them, and as soon as they hung up, I grabbed a DVD and stuck it into my laptop. As soon as it loaded, I noticed that episode 004 and now been replaced with Rip Mommy and Daddy, which quite frankly sent a deep chill down my back. Since my cousin was now asleep, I decided to plug my earbuds in so she can now sleep without having to hear what the hell was about to come out of my speakers. Normally an episode of Max and Ruby would have three short stories, but this episode only had one. It started off with quite lighthearted tone. Max and Ruby were playing tag in the garden and their parents were on the porch watching them play. However, something was off. All the sound was playing in reverse and the parents' faces were that of sadness. A film grain became present and it grew worse and worse as every second, and it panned to the mother and father when a deep voice, well, sorrow, the father seemed to speak. "Such a shame." It then cut to the short sound of static and then a large scream, which was followed by two people choking while the mother and father mumbled to each other in the background. It was impossible to understand them, but the sounds were so realistic that it physically made me sick. The screen cut to, well, screen cut the white for a split second. Then the scene transitioned over to Max and Ruby standing in front of what looked like to be a gravestone labeled Rip, Mommy, and Daddy. I then took a screenshot of it, which I'll have on screen for you right now. The two of them had no faces, and at this point, there was no sound apart from the faint static. This scene remained on the screen for a solid minute and a half before it cut to black. It then changed the scene again, now showing Max and Ruby sitting in Ruby's room, while a undecipherable whispering became apparent and grew louder over time. Both of them were sobbing uncontrollably while a transparent clips of what seemed to be a murderer in playing in reverse flashed on screen. The fellow took a knife out of his neck and picked up a bloody axe, and hacked away at this corpse of the mother before she came back and walked up the stairs. By this point, she was whispering and it became louder, and more of the whispering voices started to disappear. But the very sound of it, sound of one of these voices, became rather angry. And then out of nowhere, a very audible, "Burn in hell!" It was screaming through my earbuds. To be quite frank, this is more euphoric than anything else. The scene had changed to a more disturbing, yet the saddest thing I'd ever witnessed. It showed Max sitting in his room. He was standing on a chair with a noose hanging from the ceiling. He brought it around his neck, and then the scene faded to black. Then the static got louder. Almost instantly, it then cut to Ruby walking in on her brother. She then let out a gut-twisting scream, and this camera panned to her face as the sound of a chair being kicked. And you could, like, God, this is fucking shit. I don't even care. And then this, okay, let me just put this on screen to what I'm trying to read for you guys. I'm sorry if I just completely broke immersion. Okay. She then let out a gut-twisting scream. The camera panned to her face as the sound of the chair being kicked, well, could be heard, and some choking before then, and it began to play. The picture of Ruby's face stayed on the screen for a good 5 minutes. This time, her eyes had returned to, well, gaping noses. Holes! Holes. Okay, you know what? Jesus, sexy. Really bad. The scene cut to black with loud static, which, for fuck's sake. The scene cut to loud static when the screen returned to Ruby, which was sitting on her own now in the garden with two gravestones. One labeled "Rip Mommy and Daddy," and the other labeled "Rip Brother." She then looked at the camera and, with what? What? She then looked at the camera with glowing blue pupils, then speak to me. What? Oh, God fucking damn it. And you know what, guys? I was initially gonna read this as a completely legitimate pasta, as you may tell in the earlier parts of this. But to be honest, the grammar and everything in this pasta is quite shit. I can't take this damn thing seriously. This thing needs to be rewritten. So, essentially what happens is that she, like, the Ruby character says, "You will regret this, and death is our only release," and then the dude's parents came home, and, well, there was, like, a letter on the table that read, "Death is our only release," and, yeah. This is quite awful. This is quite an awful story. I physically can't read any more of it. You can go to the wiki if you want, but yeah, essentially it amounts to spooky, scary skeletons with reversing audio, and oh my God, this story is shit. Dear God. I don't even know how something this bad. It looked like, I promise, the guy put effort into getting screenshots, but he put 2 minutes. I mean, like, what? What? I'm broken. This story broke me. Welp, I hope you guys enjoyed another Krabby Pasta Friday. Oh, dear fucking God. Oh, dear God. I am sorry you guys had to endure that. This has been your host, That Creepy Reading. I don't even know how to can someone just, you know what I would recommend for this story? Just a complete rewrite. That's what this needs. A complete rewrite after being burned and everything being scrapped. The initial ideas are pretty cool, and I like the idea of this situation. It just has so poorly written that I want to gouge out my own eyes with a spoon. This has been your host, That Creepy Reading, and today I'm signing off. Please enjoy another Crappy Pasta Friday.